What happens next? That is the question on everyone's mind tonight.
Now, this after the bombshell announcement from independent investigators claiming Governor Cuomo sexually harassed nearly a dozen women.
And now you have everyone from the president to the governors of all of our neighboring states to local residents calling on the governor to resign. Kevin Vesey joins us now in the studio to begin our team coverage. Kevin.
And Rich, in spite of those calls for his resignation, Governor Cuomo remains defiant and appears unwilling to step down. So now all eyes are turning to the state legislature to see if they'll move forward with impeachment.
The fallout has been swift and firm. Governor Cuomo hearing calls to resign from allies and enemies alike. Even his lieutenant governor, Kathy Hochul, called his behavior, quote, repulsive and unlawful.
In light of all this, he's lost his credibility.
Michael Montezano of Glen Head is the leading Republican on the Assembly Judiciary Committee, the group overseeing the impeachment investigation. He says today's revelation by Attorney General Letitia James will likely speed up the process, but the probe is still not finished.
Numerous amount of subpoenas have been issued. They've conducted additional interviews, obtained additional documentation. So now we're trying to put everything together.
That investigation is more wide-reaching. It's also looking into the governor's multi-million dollar book deal and alleged mishandling of nursing homes during the height of the pandemic.
He has lost the public trust.
Vivian Zayas formed the group Voices for Seniors after her mother, Anna, passed away at a nursing home last year. She says the AG's report gives her hope that more wrongdoing will be uncovered.
That only gives us more optimism that we're going to find out what happened with the nursing homes and that there'll be a nonpartisan investigation into what happens to the seniors.
Meanwhile, the Albany DA announced today that he's requesting investigative materials used in the AG's probe and asking any victim to contact his office. But Touro Law Professor Richard Klein says Cuomo likely will not face criminal charges.
If we look at the range of sexual harassment charges brought against people over these years, it's rare that someone's prosecuted criminally for this.
And if the governor is going to be impeached, Democrats would have to vote in favor. Political analyst Mike Dawidziak says that could now happen.
He's really leaving no choice but to move forward with impeachment because they don't want to be looked as being complicit in stalling justice or whitewashing this situation.
So, Kevin, if the state assembly does vote in favor of impeachment, what would come next?
Well, Macy, the process here in New York is a little different than on the federal level. Unlike a presidential impeachment, if the assembly votes to impeach Governor Cuomo, the governor would immediately be suspended and the lieutenant governor would take over while the process continues with a trial in the state Senate. Rich, Macy.